SV Zefr and crew, Anna and Gary, as they explore Australia and beyond.
Well, we're about to head into Cairns.
We've been hanging out in beautiful deserted islands for a few weeks, and it has been fantastic. But I just want to go into a metropolis where there's traffic and people and an industrial area and shops and restaurants and also a safe river where we can just really chill out.
Cairns, the gateway to Australia's Great Barrier Reef. We plan to head into Trinity Inlet, come up the river and anchor somewhere around here. Not far from the cruising yacht squadron, which is in this little creek here. So we can go ashore there into the industrial area of Portsmith, get some jobs done. We can also dinghy down to the marina here and head straight into town. So yeah, I'm looking forward to it. I mean, I guess the good thing about sailing is after a while I'll also be keen to get out of there and go back to the islands. So that's cool.
Get the sails down shortly and go right up the creek.
Find a nice anchorage in Trinity Bay, is it? Or
we're going right up the river.
Past the cruising yacht club.
Yeah, and we'll anchor off probably up near the cruising yacht club.
Wherever we can, we haven't been there.
Mangrove country. Crocodile country. Yay.
Okay.
Which way the wind blows when this day is done. Breathe, breathe in the air. Set your intentions, dream with care. Tomorrow's a new day for everyone. Brand new moon and brand new sun.
For many people, Cairns is all about day trips to the reef or rainforest. We've done this in the past, so for us, Cairns is all about resupplying, catching up with friends, and enjoying the community arts and markets on offer.
Follow the sun, the direction of the birds, the direction of love. Cherish this moment, cherish this breath. Each
shed blood for what they each believe. On and on and on we go. Well, some will you see and some won't be. Truth for you and truth will lead you to a samsara. Oh, no. Let me be now, let me be us. I want to be free now, oh, oh, free to see the world. I want to walk the world, oh, let me feel my feet.
As we sail north, the atmosphere's changing. People seem more relaxed. A major highlight has been meeting some of the Cairns locals. Several people have pulled over and offered us a lift, and shop staff were incredibly helpful. In one case, they even recommended that we should not buy one of their products, that we really didn't need it.
Let me be now, let me be us. I want to be free now, oh, oh, free to see the world. I want to walk the world, oh, let me feel my feet. Let me be.
Kind of funny because we're buying Asian food and we're sailing to Asia.
Yeah.
But we've still got a month to go before we get there, so.
Yeah, yeah. I suppose you start to taste it before you get to Asia.
Yeah. Well, thank you.
Oh, you're welcome. Enjoy the journey.
Thanks very much.
Rusty's Market was a highlight, with its local tropical fruits, mangosteen, rambutans, dragon fruit and star fruits, as well as locally grown vegetables and French patisserie, and as with all markets, some colourful characters hawking their wares.
So we've just finished another shopping expedition. This is just a small sample. We did go to an Asian food shop, Cash and Carry. Dried garlic and beans and mushrooms and some spices. Rice, believe it or not, and some curry paste, tahini for hummus, quite a lot of muesli bars for overnight sales. Down here, more dry goods, biscuits, muesli, and this is something that our friends on Billaroo recommended. It's settlers, dried beef mince. Goes later, just add water. It's been recommended though that it's pretty good quality. And we have a fridge, but we don't have a freezer, so we'll take some meat cryovac. But this is just a great backup if we end up in an isolated place for a while.
Got to put it all away now.
Ah, yes.
I've got some jobs outside to do.
Oh, ha ha.
While in Cairns, I took the opportunity to fly to Brisbane to catch up with family, mainly my 91-year-old mum Vera. I got a bird's eye view of some of the reef that we have sailed past. Looking down on it from several thousand feet really gave me an idea of the enormity of this Great Barrier Reef, which is the largest living organism on the planet.
So, Gary, what are we doing today?
Well, this is our version of a water maker. We don't have a water maker, so we've got to catch rain. So the idea is the rain is going to fall on the deck, it's going to catch in the hose, it's going to be channeled down there and we'll undo the water filler and hopefully we'll be able to catch fresh rainwater.
For every beautifully maintained blue water cruiser, there's also several poor old washed up wrecks that are going nowhere fast. We call this the Boulevard of Broken Dreams, and there is one in almost every harbour or boatyard. This is where the dream of sailing can become a nightmare.
another one of Gary's anti-touristy walks. Nothing special to see here. Gary's excited. We're going to upgrade our engine from a 9.8 to a 15. We can play in with two people, but not three. Here she comes now. Thank you. Here it is. The Magic 15. We're testing the new engine for the first time with us and 30 litres of fuel and some shopping.
15 horsepower.
Here a good long while. What was your favourite part about Cairns?
The services for me, the industrial area, it had everything you would need for boats, chandleries, parts, outboards, whatever you want, it's here. And it's the last major centre for stocking food.
The markets were good, Rusty's markets, the community arts here. There was beautiful mosaics and information panels about what's happened, you know, history of Cairns, the Aboriginal people of the area, Yidinji and Jabugai. That was all really interesting. Just got to adjust the course.
Yeah, the autopilot's weaving a bit, does that when we stop in a place for a fair while.
So I really enjoyed that. And also every morning there is free stuff, free... Shit, we're really zigzagging.
Oh my god.
There's Vagabond behind us. In the morning I went along to a yoga meditation session, which was really good. Sort of got me back into a bit of yoga. And they have aqua aerobics, and virtually every day there's one or two complimentary or free activities down on the waterfront. It's a big safe river, although wind over tide can be a bit messy, but we had some really strong winds and rain, so it was just nice to be safe in a big river.
In our next episode, join us as we sail north to Cooktown and grasp the true meaning of wild and windy far North Queensland.